Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are in the world. Thank you for joining us today at the latest in the Workcast webinar series. Delighted to have you all on board again today to share some of this great content with you. Today's webinar is all about B2B video marketing. So how do we engage more prospects with video? And I'm delighted that we're being joined today by Wowza Media Systems. So I will introduce the speakers in just a second. As always, please feel free to submit your questions in using the Ask a Question button. We will be taking questions as we go along if they're appropriate, or taking a few at the end when we get there. We shouldn't be on for more than half an hour, so we look forward to sharing some of this content with you. And I'm delighted today to be joined by Holly Reagan from Wowza. Good morning, Holly.
Hi, good morning, Barney. Great to be here. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, no, that's great to have you on board. Holly, just tell us what you do at Wowza.
So I'm the content marketing manager at Wowza. Basically, I just kind of handle all the marketing content for our team.
So a very appropriate person to have on this presentation. We'll talk about what Wowza do in a second. So just by way of introduction, I'm Barney Brown. And just by way of, you know, let's just do a quick introduction to who Workcast is and then who Wowza is, to give everybody some context about why we feel like we can talk about this topic today. So Workcast, as many people who have joined us know, is a webinar platform and webcasting platform. You're watching today on Workcast, so thank you for joining us. Workcast as a platform allows organizations, specifically in the B2B space, to create really engaging, great-looking webinar and webcast experiences. And you can use those for all sorts of different parts of your communication plan, and you can create lots of different types of events, and you can see some of those on the slide today. So that's all we want to say about Workcast. We're a webinar and webcasting platform, and video is at the key of what we're in the heart of what we do. Holly, do you want to just give us a couple of minutes on, or 30 seconds on Wowza?
Yeah, so Wowza Media Systems, we're a streaming media technology company. So, you know, video is definitely the very core of everything we do. Our technology is really the engine that's behind some of the biggest brands out there. Though you may not have heard of us, you've probably heard of some of the companies that have built on our technology, like Twitter, Vimeo, obviously Workcast as well, Livestream, Periscope, just to name a few. We've been a leader in the industry for over a decade, 20,000 customers, and even more than that, I believe, in 170 plus countries around the world. So we have a range of products that, you know, all are just really about providing customers with different ways to reach their own audiences through live streaming video. So whether that's our Wowza Streaming Engine software is kind of our flagship media server product. Wowza Streaming Cloud is a managed service, end-to-end service. Wowza Clearcaster is our latest and greatest offering. That's basically a Facebook Live encoder for streaming directly to Facebook Live. And the Wowza GoCoder SDK is what developers can use to build their own streaming experiences.
That's great. Thanks, Holly. And, you know, Workcast itself uses Wowza at the core of some of our engineering to power the video streams that you're watching today. So, you know, so Wowza really well positioned to talk about video and live video as we move through the presentation. So thanks, Holly, for that. So let's just focus on, on the agenda for today. We're going to talk a little bit about why live video and video is important for B2B marketers. And we're going to talk about who's producing it, where it's used, why it's used, what kind of formats it's used in, and then what our, you know, what our options are in terms of on-demand and live streaming. And I know that Wowza have got some great stuff on their Clearcast product and Facebook Live that we'll talk about later. And then some takeaways for you, which are some conclusions and some key questions that you need to be asking yourself as you embark on your video production efforts for your content marketing. So let's crack on. I'm guessing, based on the registration form that we put out, we asked how many people were producing video. The vast majority, when I looked through it, about 80% were already producing video as part of their marketing efforts. So you know, video should be not new to anybody on this, almost not new to anybody on this presentation. But one thing I wanted to focus on was a great quote. So many people on this webinar will be using a marketing automation platform to drive their content marketing. So that'll be a HubSpot, a Marketo, a Pardot, a Salesforce, a Acton, Infusionsoft, something like that. And actually, many of those marketing automation vendors, including Brian Halligan at HubSpot, are really talking about how important the use of video is in that content marketing world now. And in fact, Brian Halligan said that 50% of content you're producing should be video. And we're going to talk a little bit about why. So like scallops and bacon, and a lovely, for us, it's breakfast time here. So that, you know, quite an appetizing view. Hopefully for those people it's tea time, they'll be getting hungry by looking at that. So why is video important? And we're just going to kind of talk, drill in here to some reports by people that we can share with you. So for, again, many of you on this will be familiar with a company called the Content Marketing Institute. If you're in B2B and you're producing content, this organization is a fantastic organization for doing research, providing resources, and help and content and strategy around content marketing. And they produced a great report last year about their benchmarks report, which talks about who's doing what with what types of content. And we can see on this slide here that the types of content B2B marketers are using for their content, you can see video already is number three, 72%. And that's pre-produced, that's on-demand video. But on the right, if you look in the text on the right, you'll see that live streaming video is now at 17%. And I guess, you know, Holly, you've seen that growing from a much lower percentage the year before to that percentage now at Wowza, haven't you?
Yeah, well, at Wowza, live streaming video is definitely kind of, you know, our bread and butter. That's what most of our customers focus on. But you definitely see as live video is kind of become more popular in the B2C space, that's also kind of spreading into the B2B space as well. So makes sense that, you know, this trend is kind of growing in the B2B arena. But, you know, we've definitely seen this as a trend for a long time. So expect to see more of it in the future.
Great, thank you. And then we kind of have a couple of other reports from Content Marketing Institute here. So there was one that they talked about, what technologies are people using? And this will be relevant for people today. And I know that Holly already mentioned some of those tools like Ustream, Livestream, those kinds of tools, Workcast, webinar tools. If you look at the kind of tools that people are using to manage all of their content, you can see that people are using marketing automation, content management systems for their website, email marketing, et cetera, but we are already now seeing webinar and online presentations coming in a number five as a key way to manage your content. And then over on the right-hand side, 25% is all to do with video tools and platforms. So, you know, we cannot ignore video as a piece of content that people want to consume, and we can't ignore the tools that we need to use to manage them. And that's kind of where Wowza comes in. It's powering a lot of these tools in the marketplace. Holly, do you want to comment on that?
Yeah, I mean, absolutely. There are definitely, you know, a growing number of tools that anyone, B2B marketers who, you know, probably aren't streaming experts, there's becoming every day more and more tools that they can use to create and publish either live or on-demand video really easily. And, you know, obviously we have a few products in our portfolio that are a really good fit for those users.
Thanks, great. And then, you know, the last chart that I wanted to show was how people are distributing access to the video. So, you know, we can see the usual suspects at the top, and we're going to talk about social later and specifically Facebook live streaming later, but using email, social media, blogs, in-person events and webinars, webcasts and virtual events as the mechanisms to get people to this video. You know, and what we see is people now having much better conversion statistics on email, for example, where video is involved. And, you know, there's some fantastic stats out there delivered by Content Marketing Institute and others that talking about, you know, video included in a email has a much bigger open rate than an email that does not include video. So who's producing video? And I guess, you know, Wowza, you've got a great view on this in the marketplace, and we'll come to you in a second. But this is a chart produced by a company called Vidyard. Some of you may be familiar with Vidyard as a company that helps you manage your on-demand video and produce personalized video for sales teams and other tools. They produced a benchmark report for 2017 that talked about the industries that are producing video. You know, I guess, Wowza, you'd see the similar spread of people using your technology. Would that be fair? Media and entertainment right out in front.
Yeah, they're definitely, you know, one of our biggest segments, but really our customers are kind of across the whole spectrum in terms of industries. So I'd say this is pretty reflective of what we see. It really runs the gamut. Everyone is starting to use video these days in their marketing strategies.
And I guess the point of putting this up is that, you know, nobody should feel excluded, right? So, you know, just because you don't have TV content or live sports to broadcast doesn't mean you shouldn't be doing it. You know, and if you actually look at the fact that manufacturing is number two, you know, they're hardly the custodians of exciting video content, but yet they're the second biggest producers of video content from a Vidyard's perspective. So, you know, for B2B, it's getting bigger and bigger, and we need to get on the bus.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, so let's dive into why video is important in B2B, which is really the heart of this. So, you know, what we decided to take a look at is where video could be used in the sales cycle. As B2B marketers, we all have a vested interest in our sales funnel, especially from content production purposes. You know, what content are we producing, which part of the sales funnel? And video is no different. So video has an opportunity to play a part at every part of the sales funnel. So whether that's part of the pre-sale, part of the you know, the sales process for the, you know, decision phase, part of the actual, the final decision-making phase, the close phase, or even post-sale. Video can be used in absolutely all parts of that sector. And I guess, you know, Wowza, you would see that, wouldn't you, in terms of your own content marketing, that you're using video throughout that sales funnel?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, it can definitely be used at every stage. We definitely do that ourselves. We have a regular Facebook Live segment that we do where we just kind of talk about, you know, trends in the industry or news within our business. We're always shooting videos at events and trade shows like the NAB show that we go to, talking to some of our customers, or even doing case study videos where our customers are kind of talking in their own words about how our products and services have helped them better serve their end users. Which, you know, obviously that's kind of a more of the end of the funnel stage. So, yeah, we really use it throughout the entire process, and we've seen our customers do that as well.
So if we talk about it, let's split it up then in terms of on-demand video. So where we would use on-demand video in that sales funnel, and where we would use live video, and what kind of videos those might be, because that's, you know, some key takeaways for this presentation. So right up at the top of the, you know, for on-demand video, I think you just mentioned some of these, top of the sales funnel. So producing, you know, we're going to talk about length of engagement in a bit as well. You know, on-demand video tends to be shorter. So we tend to see on-demand video being used at the top of the funnel, teaser videos, adverts, brands, social. You guys, I know we're doing it. You guys at Wowza, are you doing some of these kind of short snippet videos at the top end of your funnel?
Yeah, absolutely. We do one of those, you know, every week or every couple weeks.
Right, yeah, and we see, and I think we'll all be familiar with this, where we create a really short video and attach it to a social post. You know, we're not expecting people to look at it for a long time, but we're trying to get our brand out there. We're trying to get people familiar with our brand, our product, by putting entertaining, short, snack videos that people can watch on demand. You know, we're not expecting people to deeply engage with them, but it's about a promotional aspect of our brand and product. So it's an important part of on demand, is that top of the sales funnel.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, exactly. And so then down at the end of the sales funnel for on demand videos, I think you talked about some of these as well. So you talked about case studies. I think these are, you know, one of the most powerful types of on demand video for the decision stage of the sales funnel. and testimonials and how-tos, pre-recorded videos to do with product or validation about product or service that help people when they're in that decision phase. And I guess, you know, just like we produce tons of these things for on-demand mm-hmm. consumption, I guess Wowza do too. But they, again, don't tend to be very long. Is that, would that be fair? They tend to be relatively short, these case studies and testimonials, 1 or 2 minutes?
Yeah, we usually will actually kind of combine those with a blog post. So we'll have like a short video from the customer where they're kind of talking about their experience with some maybe longer form copy surrounding it and kind of going in depth a little bit more. But yeah, the videos themselves tend to be shorter in that regard.
Yeah, absolutely. So, and then, you know, and again, we're going to talk about the length of engagement, but then we'll, before we do, we'll talk about one other aspect of on-demand video nowadays, which we're seeing more and more and more, is this idea of creating content libraries. You know, we're very used to, as consumers, going to a website, a TV station, or a sports channel, or a football team, and seeing lots and lots of on-demand video for us to be able to watch, associated with topic, organized and grouped together in different ways. We're starting to see more of that in the B2B, so people grouping together their videos that they posted in different places, but bring them all together in one place on their website. You know, we see an example here from Limelight or their webinar channel where you can go and watch all their webinars. One thing I wanted to point out about this around these webinar channels and on-demand video is accessibility. And, you know, this is where Wowza really come to the fore behind some of these tools, making sure that people have a great experience. You know, Holly, do you want to talk about just that point around making sure that people can really access and watch these anywhere?
Yeah, I mean, you kind of hit the nail on the head there already. Basically, just using Wowza technology, you know, we make sure that video is encoded and delivered in formats that can be viewed on any device anywhere in the world, no matter how people are accessing your videos, whether they're on mobile or laptop, and no matter what platform they're using, what kind of connection they have, we really ensure that everyone can have the same viewing experience, regardless of how they're accessing it, and everyone has a high quality experience.
And it's not to be underestimated how important this is, right? So, you know, we as consumers all know our own behavior as consumers, that if we go and try and watch a piece of video and it buffers or stutters, or I have to download an app on my phone to watch it, or, you know, it's not accessible, or it comes out in the wrong size, or the sound's terrible, you know, we're lost, you know, as consumers. And that doesn't change for the B2B world. In fact, we're probably even more, you know, we're probably even, you know, we have even shorter attention spans in the B2B world than we do in the consumer world. So making sure that this, making this sure that video works correctly for whoever's accessing it, wherever they are, is vitally important.
Yeah, you definitely, if you're building your own service or if you're using, you know, like an end-to-end service like our Wowza Streaming Cloud, you just want to make sure you have, you know, trusted technology behind it that's going to deliver everything in the best possible
yours. And I think, you know, one of the takeaways for that we'll talk about later is this is getting easier for B2B marketers. This is no longer the domain of highly technical engineering or AV folk anymore. There are more and more tools, and, you know, we showed a slide earlier of some of the stuff that Wowza is powering that are making it much, much easier for B2B marketers to create and host and embed videos in the places that their viewers are going to be watching. And we're going to talk about that in a second.
Yeah.
Thanks, Holly. So let's talk a little bit about live. This is our two, we're both, this is our favorite subject, right? So we're a webinar company, we love live. You know, you're Wowza, you build technology to help people stream live. Why should we stream live? So, you know, let's just talk a little bit about that. Holly, you know, Wowza, I've been at the forefront of this industry for, like you say, for forever, building the best technology that helps people stream live. You know, tell us a little bit about why people should be streaming live and streaming video.
Yeah, well, really the best thing about live video is just how engaging it is. And, you know, this is something that will really hit home with B2B marketers. You know, it really just grabs audience attention, again, in an era when everyone has short attention spans, you want to be able to grab people right away and really hold their attention. Get that interaction with audiences, especially if you're doing like a social broadcast where you want to have some two-way communication directly between the broadcaster and the viewer. You have to obviously be doing that live, or they can't directly participate with you. Another thing about live video is, you know, studies have really shown that it has the best ROI of any kind of marketing content that you could be producing. It's going to stand out from, you know, all the emails that people are getting flooded with in their inbox, ads bombarding them online. It's really, you know, just something different. It's been proven to even grow revenue year over year faster than other types of marketing content and to actually drive more conversions. So, you know, this isn't just a theory that people like it better and that it's more engaging. It's really proven that it works and it gets results for marketers.
Just to put some context around that, thanks, Holly. To put some context around that, we've got a chart on screen right now that was done by one of your customers, Wowza, Ustream, under the guise of IBM Cloud. They did a survey of over 300 digital marketers talking about the benefits of live video events. And I think you've just touched on some of those, but there's some startling stats on there that, you know, nearly 80%. The benefit is 80% better engagement with audiences. You know, 80% of those 300 marketers, that's why they do live video, to get interaction with their audiences. They want to make those more accessible. You know, adding that human element, I think you just talked about it a second ago, getting access to product experts. You ran one this week, didn't you, that actually played to this point, your webinar that you ran earlier this week. You know, it was just you go ahead.
Oh, sorry. No, I was just going to say, yeah, we just last week hosted a webinar with the creators of our Clearcaster appliance where they basically just, you know, talk directly to our users and current and potential customers of our product. And they got to just ask questions directly to, you know, the people who created it themselves. And it really was an engaging webinar. It performed really well. And stuff like that is a great way to just, you know, kind of have that direct connection with the people using your products.
And there's no way, given that you've got 20,000 plus customers, that most of them would ever get access to those thought leaders in any other way. You know, that's the only way that potentially they get to ask them a question or be part of that conversation.
Yeah, absolutely.
So that's fantastic. There was a stat here as well below, which is really fascinating. I mean, we see lots of people talking about the length of engagement, and we've talked about engagement today. On-demand video has an average viewing time on desktops of 2.6 minutes, and that will come as no surprise to anybody on this broadcast. You know, people, if you're creating on-demand, people have a very short attention span. The same is not true for live. You know, on a desktop, live video viewing times average 35 minutes. So if you think about that in the form of a webinar or a broadcast or a social broadcast, you've got a much longer time keep people engaged because of the things you've talked about, because of the engagement points, the interaction points, the fact that it's live, that has a buzz associated with it, all of those things keep viewers viewing for longer. So it gives us a different type of experience. Thanks, Holly. That's great. Mm-hmm. We're going to move on to talking about social channels in a second, but one thing that we've seen is the fact that live video reaches larger audiences as well. By definition, on demand can only be watched by the people who are invited to watch it, whereas live video can reach much, much larger audiences at a point in time. I think a great example is we've produced lots of on-demand videos for our product and platform, and you know, we see, you know, registrations of 100, where we see viewers of, like, for on-demand 20, 50 people. We run a live webinar, we see registrations of 200, 300 with 100, 150 people. We just get more people, and I think the same would be true with Wowza and their, you know, video audiences as well.
Yeah, and one thing that's kind of interesting too is on social channels, it's actually been proven that the longer a video runs, the more engagement increases and the more people actually get on and start watching that. So viewership actually goes up as time goes on, or it's the opposite with on-demand.
Yeah, that's a really good point. And a nice segue into this point, which is where is live used at Holly? So we, you know, we took a snapshot of some of the areas where you can use live in this back to the sales funnel as well and the content funnel. You know, most live video for B2B marketers is used in that interest and decision phase. So, you know, it's the live Q&As, the live demos, the live product updates, training, conferences, thought leadership. You talked about one of those earlier on. You know, a product update run by thought leaders, you know, combining those two things together. And your attendance was great and your registration was great because of those two things. So let's just talk quickly about some of the types of live options that we have then. So where can we broadcast? What are the channels that we can broadcast to? So not unsurprisingly, we've got what we're doing today. Webinars and webcasts, you know, and that's the probably most common way right now of B2B marketers doing live broadcasting. But we're seeing more and more people shift to application and website streaming, so streaming from various different places to their websites. And we're going to talk about this in more detail, streaming to social platforms. Whether that's YouTube, Periscope, and then we're going to talk about Facebook in detail. Mm-hmm. So, Holly, over to you. You know, why Facebook Live? Why is Facebook Live becoming so important, you know, over, you know, as well as those other channels?
Yeah, well, Facebook Live is really becoming, you know, the most popular destination for live streaming social video. It's starting to overtake YouTube, which, you know, is kind of the long-standing titan in this area, but Facebook is actually becoming more popular than YouTube on a number of metrics. Part of this is just because of the massive reach that it has. Your audience is almost certainly already on Facebook, no matter who they are. B2C, obviously, that holds true for them, but same for B2B as well. Kind of as the consumer market goes, you know, so goes the business-to-business market. Even just for the purpose of, you know, if you're a business trying to reach other businesses, they're trying to reach their consumers and their consumers are already on Facebook Live. I mean, there's, you know, people every day accessing this platform from all kinds of different areas. And part of why it's really taking off is just because of the unique features it has for engagement. You know, Facebook has this ability for viewers to comment and send live reactions in real time while the broadcast is happening, as we mentioned, to speak directly to the broadcaster. Another kind of interesting aspect of Facebook is, you know, people are tending to really use their personal profiles more and more, even if they're using it for professional purposes. So for B2B marketers, that's great because you can really capture a lot of, you know, lead generation information just based on the profile information that they have on there. So it's a way for you to not only identify, you know, who some of these people are that you want to be reaching out to, but really gather a lot of information about them up front and speak directly to them. And that's just, you know, kind of an unprecedented opportunity. And that's why we see more and more businesses kind of getting on the bandwagon and joining all the people who are already going live on Facebook every day.
I think that's a really interesting point around the new generation of marketers and B2B marketers that are coming out where they don't create that separation between work and personal life now. You know, and I think there are people certainly of my age who probably went, well, Facebook's not the right place to get to my B2B audience. Surely that's LinkedIn. And actually that's changing, right? So, you know, I think B2B professionals are on Facebook. They are defining their jobs and their employers on Facebook. And they're not separating that personal and professional life.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I gave you the example the other day of, you know, I use my personal profile to go on Facebook Live and watch our meetings here at work. You know, I think that's just becoming a really common practice. Most people I know do the same thing. Just as Facebook becomes kind of more and more a part of our everyday lives and various other social channels as well, people are just kind of becoming more comfortable with that and it's becoming more common.
Yeah, that's great. So, you know, Facebook Live is going crazy and you know, it's overtaken YouTube now as the number one live social channel for video. So, you know, it's an And without giving you a massive plug, I think you've got a great new ebook about Facebook live streaming, have you, Holly, that people are free to download somewhere?
Yeah, we just published it last week. It's a really comprehensive resource. It's called the Wowza Ultimate Guide to Facebook Live Streaming. If you just go to wowza.com/blog, you know, you'll find it on there. It really just goes over everything you need to know about creating professional broadcasts on Facebook Live. And, you know, we also, to get a quick plug in there for our new appliance, the Wowza Clearcaster appliance, it's a, you know, a dedicated device for streaming to Facebook Live. It really just ensures the highest quality delivery, maximum reliability. So your streams, as we said before, it's not going to buffer or drop, losing your viewers in the process. So if you're really ready to get serious about streaming, definitely go check that out on the Wowza website.
Yeah, definitely. So let's kind of move into wrap up and conclusion. So I think one of the things we kind of talked about was let's, you know, come up with some questions that you need to ask yourself. If you're producing video for B2B, what questions do you need to answer before you really start? Or as you produce that, or as you're putting together that video content plan? You know, so we came up with five that we think are relevant that helps then drive what you're going to do. So the first one was, what story am I trying to tell? So I think this plays back to the sales funnel and where you are in that sales funnel, or where your audience might be in that sales funnel. You know, are you trying to promote your brand, or trying to promote a product, or are you actually trying to give somebody more in-depth information? So, you know, before you even, you know, get your camera out or your screen recording software or whatever it might be to produce your video, what story is it that you're trying to tell? And I know that, you know, this drives the kind of video that you're going to produce. Mm-hmm. I think this plays to your point, Holly. Where's the audience? I think, you know, Facebook Live is changing that dynamic. You know, we can't accept that we have those audiences in our databases anymore. Those audiences are out there, and they're in many different social and website channels. So, you know, they'll be reading magazines, they'll be online, they'll be looking at portals online, they'll be looking at different websites, and they'll be on different social channels and groups and stuff like that. And so we need to be able to figure out whether the video that we're producing is going to reach that audience. I know that, how do you do that for Wowza? I mean, Wowza, for example, for some of their products is a very engineering type audience, and some it's more of a B2B marketer type audience. So you guys, I guess, are picking different channels all the time.
Yeah, and our users who use Wowza products as well, you know, one way that our products in our portfolio really help people reach their end users wherever they are is, you know, through that syndication, which we kind of mentioned before, how, you know, you can send the same broadcast to multiple different channels at once. So you can send one stream out and hit your website, Facebook, YouTube Live, you know, you can really get that multi-destination delivery through products like our streaming cloud service or our streaming engine service. So you definitely want to be thinking about all the different places that you need to be reaching people, you know, whoever your audience is, they're going to be living in a bunch of different places online.
They are indeed. What production values do I want? I think this is a, you know, great point that many B2B marketers struggle with. You know, that everybody thinks that they have to have the highest possible production value, but actually it can completely range from, you know, short, highly produced videos to very simple screen share type videos that people are producing. So, you know, there is no right answer, but there clearly is a scale, you know, and there's a scale that says that, you know, some videos for some parts of the funnel, it's absolutely fine if it's just voice over PowerPoint or voice over screen sharing. And there are some, you know, things where it needs to be much higher production value. You know, if you're doing conference broadcasting to Facebook Live, you probably need to be investing in something like Clearcaster so that the audience has the best possible experience. You know, so I think that's a really, you know, important question. And it's people like Wowza and Wowza Technologies that are really driving that product, you know, helping ensure that the video quality that the person's watching is of the highest quality it can be.
Yeah, and there's a setup that you can really put together to create videos that look and sound great, for a range of budgets, So it kind of just depends on I think this leads into our next question, but whatever you have to work with, you can put a workflow together that's going to still give you a really high quality end product.
Absolutely. And, there is some great stuff on the Wistia and Vidyard websites about what equipment, if you're at the low end and want to produce video for the first time or on low budget, there's some great examples there of the simple kit that you can get together for a few hundred dollars that can actually produce surprisingly high quality video for on demand. And then, there are tools out there that help you then stream this live as well. So go and take a look at some of those.
And our ultimate guide goes through those workflows for Facebook as well.
Okay, that's good. Yeah, that's good to know. So we'll distribute the. Actually, Holly, here's an ask for in a light. It'd be difficult for you to say no when we put out the on demand for this. Can we share that ebook, the Facebook ebook from you guys with the audience?
Absolutely. Yeah, I'd love to share it with everyone.
Yeah, lots of people asking for the slides, and we'll share that ebook as well. So that'd be great. And then I guess a really important question is, does it need to be live or not? And I think Holly, why don't you talk to this point? Because I think you guys are the experts on this.
Well, I think we touched on this a little bit before, but really the main answer to this question is, if you are engaging with your audience, it needs to be live. If you want to be able to talk directly to the people who are watching. Also, if it's a time-sensitive broadcast, if it's, a major event that's going on, or if it's something where the outcome is unknown, like a sports game or an award show, anything where there's either that kind of time-sensitive element or where you're directly talking to the people who are watching, then it needs to be live to really have that level of engagement that you want.
Yeah, absolutely. Great questions coming in here now, just that we can see now. So keep those questions coming. We'll handle some of those in a second. Got a question here about simulated live. It's a great point, and actually that hybrid between the two about pre-producing video and broadcasting it as live. Wowzer's tools certainly can help with doing that kind of thing. And we use it for that exactly that purpose.
Are we switching to that? Are we going to finish these?
Last question. So last question you need to ask yourself. So what skills and resources do I have in-house? And I think you talked about this a little bit earlier on. It really just, I think it depends on the answers to two of the previous questions, which are, what production value do I want? And does it need to be live or not? And the answer to those two questions will drive what kind of skills and resources you need to have in-house. I think, and you talk, Holly, about a number of tools out there now that are making this easier and easier.
Yeah, no, absolutely. And again, just kind of at any, whatever your budget is, whatever you have to work with, you can put together a workflow that's going to work for you. So, whether that's kind of a consumer or prosumer camera and basic setup, if you're using just some software such as like a Wirecast or something that's, more affordable kind of entry-level product to start getting your broadcast online, you can put something like that together for pretty cheap. And that goes all the way up, there's all kinds of gradients in the middle there, but going all the way up to the high end where, you're a professional broadcast studio with a control room set up, and you're using the top-of-the-line equipment and, using something like the Clearcaster that's a really professional-grade encoder to just deliver that video to your online destinations and maybe as well as to traditional broadcasting destinations. You can really kind of find something that's going to work for you no matter what you have to work with.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. So just drawing this up to some conclusions now. So I think, we've covered all of these. So one of the things that we're saying is, video has to be a part of B2B's content marketing mix. If we don't, we're going to be behind other people. And also, video is the best converting type of content that marketers are seeing right now today, both on demand and live. And so, you need to base that video strategy on your existing content and funnel strategy. So it needs to become part of the same thing. We need to use the different videos for different parts of the funnel. We talked a little bit about the difference between short on-demand videos and where to use live videos. Some great examples from Holly about, you know, why we would use live and where we'd use live and, you know, when we choose to use that. We definitely need to make sure that the tools that we use are robust and reliable and scalable. You know, we have to make sure that our audience is able to access it easily from any device, any machine, any operating system, and has a good experience. Tools out there are getting, you know, easier and easier to acquire, use, rent, and produce video. So it's getting so much easier. And you know, us as B2B marketers, that's you know, Holly and me and the audience today, we are the custodians of this. We don't necessarily produce it all, but we are the custodians of what gets produced and where it gets distributed. And so we need to make sure that we are producing the right video for the right part of the sales funnel at the right quality, and live where it needs to be live. So, you know, let's all go and create more video. Anything to add to that, Holly, before we move on to a couple of questions?
No, I mean, I think you really covered everything really well. You know, video is not just a passing fad. This is kind of the way that everything's going. More and more of all of the content that you're finding online nowadays is going to be video-based, and that's not going to change anytime soon. So everyone definitely on board.
Yeah, we just look at anything. We look at anything in this marketplace, and we look at stuff that starts in the consumer world and ends up in the B2B world. And you know, that's just the nature of the beast. And you know, video is all over consumer world, and now it's emerging and growing rapidly in the B2B world as well. So so a couple of questions. A question here about Wowzer's experience with Facebook Live. What kind of organizations are using streaming to Facebook Live at the moment, you know, that Wowzer are seeing?
I mean, again, it really kind of cuts across the spectrum. All different industries are starting to use this, but one of the biggest segments, you know, that we've seen, perhaps not surprisingly, is going to be kind of these professional broadcasters or live event producers. So people who are maybe broadcasting live sports, so be news stations, you know, morning shows, would also be, you know, video production studios, where maybe they're producing segments on behalf of other brands or other personalities, celebrities, musicians. So kind of that traditional broadcaster segment that's now growing, establishing this online presence, is definitely a really big one that we're seeing. But it really is everywhere. I mean, you know, like we've talked about in this presentation, B2B organizations, enterprise, another big segment as well. Government organizations are even, you know, using video to kind of foster that civic engagement and get citizens to participate. So really, in any type of organization you can think of is getting online and going live and producing all kinds of video nowadays.
Yeah, and a great question here from, you know, the education sector, which is, you know, we didn't actually put video in this presentation, although the broadcast itself is a video. We didn't have yours and I cameras on. You know, I think it's a really great question. When do you use cameras and when don't you use cameras? And for B2B, it's always a debate about whether having the person on camera adds any value to the content that they're presenting. You know, and if it does, then there's a good reason to have a camera on. If it doesn't, then there's no reason to have the camera on. You know, part of the presentation was to hear Holly and I talking about the stuff that was on the slides, not necessarily to see, as attractive as we both are, Holly, the purpose of this webinar was not to look at you and I, it was to hear and see the content that we were presenting. So it's a great question about when do you switch a camera on, and you know, it depends, again, it goes back to one of those five questions. What kind of content are you trying to produce? And, you know, and who's your audience? So that's a great question.
Yeah, what's going to engage them as well. So in this case, like you said, what's kind of the most engaging part of the presentation is some of the information that we're presenting and the infographics and examples that we're showing on the slides. But, you know, if we didn't have that, then people need something to look at. So really on what you're showing and what's going to really capture people's attention and keep it there.
Absolutely. Great. So we're at 45 minutes. So I want to thank you, Holly, for joining me today and sharing us that Wowza knowledge that you have and what Wowza are doing in the live streaming industry. And I'm really looking forward to sharing the Facebook Live ebook with the audience today. So there's some good questions about social media managers coming in that we haven't got time to answer. So thank you, Holly, for joining us today.
No, thank you for having me. It was great, and I really am looking forward to sharing our ebook with everyone. I think people are gonna really find it useful, and you know, definitely look forward to doing more with you in the future.
Great, thank you. And thank you, audience, for joining us for this latest webinar from the WorkCast program. Next webinar we have again is about video on the 21st of February, and we'll be joined by the VP of Marketing from Vidyard, Tyler Lessard, who's going to be talking about his video predictions for 2018. So that'll be a really great presentation too. I want to thank you all for joining. Thank you, Holly. Thank you, Wowza. And thank you, audience. And we'll look forward to seeing you soon.
Yeah, thanks a lot.